So what is your range formula? R equal to u square sine 2 theta by g. So just substitute here 29 into sine 45 into 2. What is that? Sine 90. What is sine 90? By 9.8. If you do this problem, you can get your answer is 85 meter. So the boundary is at the distance of how much? 80 meter. Will you score 6 or 4? 6. Repeat the same problem with the angle 30 degree. What is your answer? R equal to, what's that? Again 29 into, what's that? Sine 60. What is sine 60? How do you get sine 60? Sine 2 into 30, sine 60. Why? What's that? 9.8. If you calculate, you are getting 74 meter. Will it be 6 or 4? So what did you understand from this? What did you understand from this? So the angle of, let's say, projection should be 45 for getting maximum range. That's the concept here. Now we pass on to another scenario. Just looking at the scenario. Of course, traveling the 3 person in a vehicle is wrong, offense. Of course, we are riding. At that time, we are caught by the traffic police. He told us to stop. So we are putting our brake immediately. Automatically, we have a skid over the road for a distance, isn't that? Circuit problem, yeah. So we have a distance of skid, say 6 meters. 6 meters. Nearby we have a signboard, say 40 kilometer per hour. You have to identify whether he is over speeding or not. Don't worry about 3 persons here. You just identify whether he is over speeding or not. For that we just do this problem like this. You take your equation, same equation, v square equal to u square plus a. What is their final velocity? Your initial velocity, that is the thing we want to know, is it that? Alam therin. What is your distance of skid? 6 meters. The maximum acceleration in their left is 9.8. Of course, retardation, so put a minus. So automatically, 0 is equal to u square minus 2 into 9.8 into what? 6. If you calculate your value of u, root of 12 into 9.8, your answer is supposed to be 10.8 meter per second. But please convert it into kilometer per hour. So just take 10.8 into 18 by 5. So if you calculate here, your answer is 39 kilometer per hour. So what do you conclude? Whether it is overspeeding or not? Overspeeding or not? He is not overseen. Will you find or not? Find one wrong, yeah? Definitely. Why? Overloading. Is it that? Are you clear? So I have imparted certain things here. Moral as well as science here. Okay? Now we pass on to the next concept. For example, in a javelin throw, the maximum height he can achieve is h. What might be his maximum range? maximum height போறது ஹெச்னா maximum range எவ்வளவு இருக்கும். So you just take the same formula, r equal to u square sin 2 theta by g for finding range. That is equal to u square by g. For finding the height h, you just take the formula, what's that? H u square sin square theta by what? 2g. For having maximum height, the angle of projection must be 90. Only when you throw upward like this, you can achieve maximum height. So you are getting h equal to u square by 2g. So from this, what is the value of u square h by g? 2h. So automatically we can say that the longest distance might be 2 times the, yes, write it, what is your r? R equal to 2h. So what might be the longest distance twice the maximum height? Twice the maximum height. Of course, we have to remove all the other concepts. Certain things say air friction, all this is here. Okay? Is it clear enough? Is it clear enough? Right. Now we pass on to the next problem. You just assume there is an escalator. If you stand, you will take it to another floor. If the escalator is at rest, you will be taken to the other floor in 5 seconds. If you are standing on the escalator will take you to the other floor in 2.5 seconds. If both of them are moving, both, what is your time taken? The concept is relative velocity only. Relative velocity. What is that? So when the escalator is at rest, what is your speed? Distance by how much seconds? When the escalator is alone working, 2.5. Both of them are working, you add it. That is your time taken. So what is your 1 by g? 1 by 5 plus 1 by 2.5. Just take the LCM. So what is your t here? It is equal to 1.8. That's all. So the concept that you have to apply here is relative concept. Are you clear? If you are going against opposite direction, that might be different. Next, same type of problem. It is not a problem for you to understand here. It is projective motion only. A hunter is aiming a monkey. By the time the monkey was on the tree branch, soon after seeing the arrow is released from the hunter, it starts jumping. Will this arrow hit this monkey or not? The arrow varada paathu monkey jump panniruchu. If the arrow monkey hit panna panna, yes or no? Answer is yes. How sir? The answer is the vertical displacement of this arrow and the vertical displacement of this monkey are same. So automatically the arrow will definitely hit the monkey. Once if the monkey was in the branch itself, if you want to hit, you got to hit only at the higher place only. You have to aim high. Only when you aim high, automatically your vertical displacement will also consider and against it will hit the mighty. Argena. So whenever we are having any projectile motion, we have to consider the vertical displacement. Next. The ball is dropped from a height h. What's the time taken to reach the time taken to reach the ground is 4 seconds. What is the height? The formula is very simple here. That is s equal to ut plus, this is your height h. Your initial velocity is 0 because it is dropped, not pushed. So you are running equal to 9.8 into how much? 4 squares. So you are going to multiply it and your answer is 80 meter approximately. Are you there? Now next one. For example, a soldier is going on shooting, say n bullets of each mass m with the velocity v, what is the force exerted on the machine gun? The concept is very simple here. Force Newton second law. What is that? Rate of change of momentum. What is that? Change in momentum. By how many bullets? N bullets. Each bullet is moving with mass m, velocity v. So momentum mv. So that is a change in moment. By time, here it is 1. So what is your force exerted on the machine gun? Yes, n into mv. Are you got it? Next, it is a very interesting one. Let me identify whether you are intelligent or not. For example, there is a box of length 5 meter, breadth 4 meter, height 3 meter. 5, 4, 3. What is the longest stick that you can place inside the box? The idea is very simple here. In your 12th standard you are studying, if you want to find the position vector of a diagonal point, r vector equal to, what is that? Is it done? So what is your modulus of r vector? Root of? So what is your answer? It is approximately 7 point something. Is it done? 7.04 meters. So whenever you want to approach any problem, you just use this type of concept, say vector notation. So this is your coordinate system 0 0 0. This is 5 4 3. What do you say? So when you want to draw any line, you draw a line like this. If you want to find its length, what to do? Just find the position vector of this point, in the point of the position vector with gap. You write it like this. Find its modulus. You can easily get it. Likewise, you might have studied in your 12th standard what's the length of your cube, root 3a. In max, root 3a. For a square, what's the diagonal? Root 2a. The concept is very simple here. A I vector plus a j vector, automatically, if you take the modulus, root of a square plus a square, root of 2a square, so root 2 into a will come out. So that is the method. Likewise, in 12th standard you have studied cube. Likewise, here I have asked another question here. That the other question is, if there is any insect is traveling urundupodu from this place to this place, what might be the shortest distance? What might be the shortest distance if it is traveling from this point to this point? So it can go in number of ways. It can go in this way. It can go in this way. it can go in this way, whatever. The correct concept here is you just imagine in this way. You just imagine there is a box like this. Are you clear? Right. Now, you are trying to find that insect is trying to move from here to here, opposite points. Now, for that, what I am doing now, I am taking this portion and I am putting down like this. So, what is this point? This point might be there, this point, no. Now, you just draw the line here. So, this might be the shortest distance. How, sir? What is this length, sir? This is 5. This is. So, what is your distance? What is your position coordinate? For example, if you take here 5 y vector plus a. Sorry, 7 j vector. Automatically, when you take its model as root of 25 plus 49, root of 74, it might be 8.6 meters. So, for all the problems which you are facing day to day life or any critical situation, just apply Venter notation analysis. Definitely, you can get the answer for it. Very simple. You can try with another possibilities here. Another possibility, this side open, that side open, all these things here. Among all these things here, this might be the shortest distance. Now, same day, another question I am asking here. That's a tap. It can fill the other tank, the tank, with the water, say 20 minutes. Another tap is there, B, which can fill in 40 minutes. There is small hole here, it can ooze out the water in 60 minutes. If all the three are open, A open, B open, and the two hole is also open, what's the time taken to fill this tank? The concept again, which we have discussed in the escalator, volume of the tank, by the time taken to fill here is V by how much? V by 40 or 60 or 40. The ooze out minus V by 60. If you solve, you can get the value of T. It may be 17.14 meters. Got it? So you have to think in this way only, relative concepts. Now let us check. What is acceleration here in this graph? Acceleration is, what's that? Rate of change of velocity, small thing here, or delta V by delta T. Automatically, when you look into this, the velocity is going on increasing within the time 25 seconds. So what is your increase in velocity? 50 meter per second by 25 is equal to 2 meter per second square. This is the acceleration here. Now, what happened to this point? Is there any change in velocity? It is started 50 meter per second, ends with the same 50 meter per second. Is there any increase or decrease in velocity? No. So, for another 25 seconds, there is no change in velocity. So, its acceleration is? What about this one here? It was started 50, now becomes 0. So, final minus initial by the time taken, 16.7. So, it is minus 3 meter per second. So, whenever you have a graph like this, you have to study the graph in this way. Got it? Now let me do one more problem here. We have, in the train we have attachment like this one. As an engineer, we must be very care about the coupler which we are using to join the two cabins. In this way, this type of problem might be useful for you. When you want to find the tension T1, what to do? First you want to find the value of acceleration A. Acceleration A is equal to force by all the masses. Is it done? What is that here? 60 by 10 plus 20 plus 30. How much? 60. So what is your value here? 1 meter per second square. That is the total acceleration of the whole system. Now let me take the acceleration of, say, the tension T1. What is your tension T1? M1 into? Sorry, M3 into A. What is your M3? 10 into 1. So the force available here, it is 10 newtons. What about the tension T1, sorry, T2 here? T2 must be M1 and M3 plus M2 into A. So that might be 10 plus 20 within bracket into 1. So it might be 30 newton. 30 newton. So this force must be 30 newton. This must be 10 newton. Likewise, we are having the situation. Okay, now? So whenever you are putting any coupler for the last carriage, if it is having less withstanding capacity, no problem. If you are putting in the beginning, automatically, you could not get that carriage with you for all the time. Somewhere it will be left. And you have a part in the itself, yeah? So likewise, we have such a thing. Next. Whenever we are rolling any object, if it is under both linear motion as well as, what's that? Rotational motion. What is the kinetic energy of the system? What is the kinetic energy of this spine? What is the kinetic energy? If you say linear motion, it is having velocity v, mass m, angular velocity, moment of inertia, and all this is here. So how do you find the total kinetic energy of this one here? Kinetic energy of linear motion plus kinetic energy of rotational motion. How much? Half m plus half I omega square. So simply taking half mb square will not solve the problem. So what to do? You have to look into the what? Angular kinematics also. That is angular velocity also. And again angular kinetic energy also into account. Then only you can get the correct answer. For example, sometimes in this building you can see two persons may be going on climbing a rope and whitewashing or covering all this is in the building. Like this. So if you are advising the other person standing here or the, for the same person, the same rope, how much amount of force he has to impart? But this concept is very simple here. Upward force, how much? T plus T. What's your downward force? What's your downward force? 2,000 or 1,000? 1,000. So it is equal to 1,000. So what must be the tension here? What's that? 500 newton. So when he wants to climb up, that is move up, he has to pull the rope. Is it done? With the force, it must be equal to, what's that? 500 newton force. Then only he can able to go up. Otherwise, it will be a difficult task for him. So for that, what we are doing nowadays, we are assigning small motors. Are you clear that? In the cinema, we have seen that the small rope is attached to them. So whenever they want to go up, we are pressing the button, the motor functions, and hence it is
PRC is coming to output.
Once you release, we are releasing. Not all of them, we release slowly only. Likewise, we have another situation here. The same concept here only. Here, how many tensions are there? 1, 2, 3. So, 3T, that is 3T. Is equal to how much goes here? 150 newton. Each T must be equal to how much? 50 newton. So, whenever we are increasing the number of strings in the pulley system, mechanical advantage increases. And again, with the least effort, we can able to lift any object. Are you listening or not? Are you understanding the class or not? Likewise, whenever you want to lift this horse, you look into the number of rows here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 6 T's are there, is equal to the weight of this horse. So that much amount of force we have to apply it. Is it possible? If it is possible, how much amount of force we have to give to move up? He has to apply the force equal to his weight plus the weight of the block plus the weight of the pulley system, rope, everything here. Then only he can able to move up. Otherwise, no use in this type of climbing problems. So we have to do more about the mechanical advantage always here. I'll be here. Next, very simple question only. Angular velocity. We have, this is called second hand after watch. What is your angular velocity? For one repetition, how much angle is there? What's the time taken to rotate? Once, revolve once? 60 seconds. What is the angular velocity of your unique hand? Tell me, 2 pi by, what's the time taken? 60 into 60. What's the angular velocity of your other hand? 5 pi squared. So, we don't, are you all understanding or not? You will not write, just to understand. What is your angular acceleration in all the cases? 5. There is no change in angular velocity. What is angular acceleration? Change in angular velocity by time. Is there any change in angular velocity? And again, the angular acceleration is 0. Now, you just imagine there is support. Two books I have mentioned like this, the place like this. And there is a paper. Let me place this paper on the support and this can on this paper, like this. Like this. Can you keep this can, a liquid can, on this place or not? Is it possible or not? Why? The paper cannot withstand. That is a concept. But it is possible. How it is possible?
Missing the number of papers.
Number of papers you should not increase. You only use only one paper. You can do it in this way. Once if you are making it in the form of a corrugated paper like this, bending like this, automatically the strength of the paper will increase. And again, if you place it, then it's done. How's that? For example, the mass of this one is say 90 gram. If it is rested the supports like this, let me write it in the other place. Like this. Three supports. If you are keeping paper like this. Okay? like this. See here, this is the force acting in this direction, force acting in this direction. The total force acting here is how much? 90 gram weight. Let it be 90 gram weight. So what must be the force acting on each? 30 gram weight is acting. Of course, let it be this angle, say 45 degree. What is the force acting in this direction? 30 into cos 45. Likewise, here also 30 into cos 45. Of course, this is 30 by root 2, is it done? This is also 30 by root 2, is it done? When you take that 30 by root 2 here, your value may be very less. How much? It is 21.2 gram of weight only design. So this much portion of paper can easily withstand this much amount of weight. Whereas the entire paper, if you apply the force, it could not withstand. So using this type of idea only, we are having a cantilever. In this main building, you can see in the front, there is a cantilever without any pillar. So whenever you are going to make any sort of cantilever system like this, you want to make it this way. I think in the other building, this building you have the same thing which I have mentioned here. Like this, you have a shape like this. So if you are doing like this, automatically you can increase the span of the flow. So when you are in the lift, you are measuring your mass in three ways. One, when the lift is adjusted, your mass will be the same mass which you have. Say for example 60 kg, you are doing 60 kg. If you are in a lift which is moving upward with acceleration g, the reading will be how much? The reading will be two times mg, 2 mg. So your weighing machine reading is 120 kg. Whereas the same lift is falling down. Now your weighing machine will say falling down to the g value, g, acceleration equal to g. Your weighing machine will show how much? Zero only. So you feel weightlessness. That's what we people are always trying. Where do you find weightlessness? You can put our astronaut there and you can make training all these things here so that they can easily accommodate in the other planets or other things like this. So in this way, while we are having acceleration in downward to g, you feel weightlessness. Now, if there is any flight moving with velocity v at a height h, what is the tangent by the desired drop? The word is drop by it. What's your answer? What's the tangent? Use it. Ut plus half, it is by h. You are dropping it. So initial velocity 0 plus half into g into t square. So your t equal to 235. That's all. Very simple concept only. So after this time, this result will keep here. So by the time you run it, so you can easily escape from the place. Agree or not? So likewise, you have to calculate it.